tell you that I love you 100 times a day. You'll get tired.
Salut à tous, nous sommes de retour au World Series of Poker. Le tournoi numéro 47, un No Limit Hold'em à 5 000 $, a débuté il y a quelques heures. Pour pire qu'à la Musa, les choses ne se sont pas passées comme prévu, avec une élimination aussi douloureuse que rapide. Mais nous gardons nos caméras braquées sur cette épreuve, car pour Joao Vieira, les choses se passent beaucoup mieux. Personne n'a oublié le triomphe du Portugais lors de l'édition 2019 des championnats du monde, lorsqu'il avait dominé de bout en bout la finale du 5 000 $ Six Max devant les caméras de votre série préférée. Et c'est plus motivé que jamais que l'ancien basketteur pro a retrouvé Las Vegas. Quelques mois plus tôt, il était couronné roi des joueurs de poker en ligne, en accédant à la première place du classement des plus grands gagnants de l'histoire des MTT Online. Un accomplissement qui lui avait d'ailleurs valu la reconnaissance du milieu, avec la une de Card Player, le doyen américain des magazines de poker. Aujourd'hui, on retrouve Joao alors qu'il vient d'enchaîner deux beaux résultats dès son arrivée en ville. Une troisième place sur un tournoi de lowball, une variante pour spécialistes, et une cinquième place en format short deck. Aujourd'hui, c'est dans ce bon vieux No Limit Hold'em que Joao va faire parler son talent. Pour l'instant, tout roule. Après 3 heures de jeu, notre héros a multiplié son tapis par 3. Il a largement de quoi nous offrir du beau spectacle. Joao, c'est à toi.
Today we're playing in the 5K, 5K 8 Max, one of my favorite tournaments. The things have been going pretty well already. I'm here for a month in Vegas. I got a couple of final tables under my belt already, and things are going pretty well, you know, in Vegas. Time flies. When you don't win a tournament, sometimes you lose track of what's going on, but so far so good. This tournament also started pretty well. This 5,000, we started with 50,000 chips, already have 150, so the first few levels were really good. Have jacks. Just gonna make my normal raise. Have a few guys on my left who are quite aggressive. Call from the hijack. This is Pistons 87. It's a player I've been playing for many, many years online and also live. Pretty good player. Ankush Mandavia. He plays a lot of hands, usually plays 13. Them pretty well. And big blind. Is Mark an English regular as well? He's been usually more on the solid side. But a very experienced player as well. This is not the worst board for me, obviously. But I don't know if I'm gonna bet. Mark could put me in a lot of situations. I think I'm gonna check. And just play some pot control. Maybe Ankush is gonna play. He's gonna put some chips in and I can maybe raise. Or just decide to slow play. Let's see what he's gonna do. Looks like he's betting. Bet quite small. I don't know if Mark comes and raises. This is gonna be an interesting spot. He's gonna have a lot of force. Probably gonna play some draws very aggressively. This could be an interesting and complicated spot. Looks quite weak though. Okay, this is good. Doesn't look like he has much. I think he would have probably raised most of his best hands. And they look quite weak, to be honest. And yeah, versus Ankush, I'm quite well. He could have 6s, 7s, 8s, just some backdoors, some overcards. My hand is pretty good. I think I'm just gonna raise, and I'm gonna raise big. To try to deny some equity, try to value bet Ankush mostly. He's gonna have a lot of pairs. what really bet against my hand. And I can take Mark out of there with some of his draws. Maybe I'll go for 6, maybe I'll go for 9,000. The pot is 79 now. Yeah, I'm gonna make it 73. Quite comfortable, it doesn't have much. So if he decides to play some of his draws aggressively, I'm gonna go with it. Yeah, I'm good. He looks pretty weak. He's about to fold. Yeah. Right, that's a good one. Yeah, let's keep building this castle. Ace queen suited. I don't know much about that guy.
17.
It looks like a professional, a regular, but I haven't played with him a lot. I think I'm just gonna flat. I could 3-bet as well, but I think I'm just gonna go with like this. The big blind isn't playing a lot of hands. Let's try to bring him in. Push calls, you could have a lot of hands, you could have a lot of hands that dominate. Okay. Didn't want it this big of a party, but my hand still plays all right. I think it's too weak. It should have some pretty strong range here. At least something solid. Is he betting 4 ways? Under the gun versus cutoff and small blind. My head is still alright here, but I think I'm just gonna call. And see what's up. You have his king, you have some ace jack, maybe ace 10. 9-7 is a possibility, but I don't think he's betting. Without any equity.
Wait, one player left.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Does Ankush have? Ankush could have another. Ankush is a bit sticky. He can probably still overcall some aces that are pretty good against. He could have some of those straight draws. Yeah, he could have 7-8, he could have 10-8. Suited. It could be slow playing as well. I gotta proceed with caution. Might be behind one of them, maybe two. Yeah, it looks like I'm probably be looking to improve or get away from the pot. I don't know, let's see. Okay, not flush draw, I'm not going anywhere for now. I think the undergun now. Under the gun will have to defy his hand. Okay. Okay, I could be good versus him. He could still have something like his king or something. Ankush is the one that I'm most worried about now. I think I have an easy check back. I don't want to play a big pot right now. Ankush could be slow playing some stuff. Yeah, let's see this river. That's a blank. If they both check, I'm probably fine. But if any of them bet, I think I'm just gonna fold. I don't think nobody's gonna bet worse than ace queen. And there's not many bluffs left. Especially from Ankush. I do look like I have a hand like this, like one pair. So if it's not the worst spot to bluff, but it's very hard for him to have. Maybe 10-8, but that's pretty much it. And he's betting into two guys. If under the gun calls, it's just an easy fold. And then if he calls, I'm probably third place. But even if he folds, I think I'm just gonna muck it. Probably has something like my hand as well. Yeah, I think 10-8 suited is my best. It's my only hope, but then he can still have 8-7, 8-9, 8-5, maybe a 6. 6 is that he's slow played. This doesn't look good. He's not calling the flop with the 9 that he would turn into a bluff. I don't think he has 5-7 suited on the small. He might not have a 10-8 suited, to be honest. And I think he would slow play some of the two pairs and trips on flop. It's a rainbow board. If he raises, it looks a little strong, and maybe he's just gonna overcall. Small chance I can tie, but still. Maybe squeeze is pretty, yeah, that's no good here. Alright. Play this one. This guy's been playing a lot of hands. He's in the button, so. My top pairs will still be pretty strong against his range. I think this is an Indian professional, but I'm not really sure. I haven't seen him much, but he's young. He's been playing so far. Hasn't done anything out of the ordinary. I think I'm just gonna c-bet here. Have a gut shot to the nuts. Rainbow board, I can go pretty small. The button has been playing quite aggressively and quite erratically, so I don't want to go. Just gonna play it small c-bet, see what's up. Try to hit my gut shot. If I feel one of them is weak, I'll just probably barrel. Especially versus the big blind. Where's this button? He didn't like, it doesn't seem very strong, but could have some weak queens, you could have some weak aces, he's gonna take a lot of hands, maybe you can have even offsuit aces. Let me try to hit him. This is not the greatest card. I don't have clubs. I don't think I'm. I don't feel like going for a big bluff versus this guy. Doesn't seem like the kind of guy that's gonna fold an ace. Maybe he has a queen, but I don't know. Okay, I have some like king 10, jack 10, but I have some bad blockers for that. If he checks back, he probably has a queen. Have some out. Doesn't look like a check back. It doesn't look very strong. But I don't want to go bananas here. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna let it go. This could be expensive. I'm not trying to bluff a guy. I have an ace here. My stack's pretty good. Doesn't seem like the guy's gonna fold much. Alright. It was cheap. Cheap one. That's alright. Hand before the break. There's usually a guy that goes out of line. Sounded like a German accent, so makes it even more likely that he's a pro. Okay, this is an easy one.
I gave it all away. I had it, but I don't have any more change.
You raise to 18, I call 18. Next 36. We have 48 in the middle. I think he played like 35. Okay. Probably gonna see bet this with a high frequency. That's not one third, that's not one fourth. This is life, maybe. Well, I don't know. Pros usually go exactly one third. It's still most likely a pro. I think I'm just gonna check call. I can check raise as well. Try to deny some equity, but six of hearts, you can go either way. I should leak this one.
Once again, players, once a hand is completed, your table, please.
The nice amount of equity.
So we can get cleaned up for the next level. Yeah.
He's most likely gonna check back. If you bet. Yeah, okay. If you. Well, doesn't matter now. Nine. You can still have a lot of aces. I don't think you have anything but a check. Let's try to check and see the showdown. Could possibly go for a bluff. Blocking bet doesn't make any sense. He's hand's the strong to bluff too. I'm just gonna check and see. Try to get a showdown. If he bets, maybe I go bananas. Maybe I fold. Maybe I call. I don't know. All right, this is good. Probably my. Oh, it's jack. All right. So let's see how many I have. 100, 125, 135. I think I'm doing good. It's been a while since I played some live poker, so it's been great to go back to live, get away from the computer, see people face to face. Vegas is great, you don't have to wear a mask while you play, at least that's quite comfortable. So it's been such a great feeling to just come back to the action, just see everybody. Everybody's so much nicer this year after the pandemic. Well, in the middle of the pandemic, it's been really fun. Much different vibe than usual.
What's that?
Giuseppe, very well known Venezuelan player, nice guy. Did the guy just got some barbecue? All right, I can play this one. Some short stacks around, maybe I can. Knock a guy out. Well, sure looks like I'm gonna try. Nobody comes. Let's see if somebody wants to join the party. Nope. We're good. Let's see.
Jacks.
Alright. Fair flip.
Lock.
Keep him low, dealer. Keep him low. That's alright. That's okay. I got hearts. Come on, dealer. Say, keep him low. Alright. 33 big blind, super standard. I was looking good. Where did you grab that ace of spades from? Let's see how many I have. 100, 110, 130, 112. Yeah. Yeah, 112. I'm still alright. Still early.
Swedish?
Yeah. Oh, actually it's Swedish. That was all for this. I never really wanna know. I just wanna know if it's a regular or not.
My rate was way off. I would've guessed the opposite. 21.
I look very Swedish, right?
Yeah.
You can
look. I think it's the other way, like you could pull off Swedish.
It's an interesting one. Can't see a stack. Well, doesn't really matter with my hand.
75.
Not really sure how many chips does he have though. Mm-hmm.
I just go with whatever benefits me. Like, so half Colombian, half British. So when I applied for, grants and stuff in college, I'd say I'm
Mark doesn't really like to fold. Okay. So far, so good. If he four bets, would have been interesting. So it's like 75, 17 in the middle.
You got about 100 back?
Oh, he's got a lot of chips.
But it ended up being amazing.
Yeah. Shouldn't have many kings. Strong kings. Nines and eights are possibility. I don't think he has his king. He called a little fast. I could just... I'm just gonna make a small bet. It's a pretty good board for me. You could have some straight draws. You could have some 9x, 8x. Maybe I can fold out some equity. I don't think he's gonna attack this board.
43.
I'm gonna keep it simple. Okay. I'm just gonna have some kings, like king queen suited, king jack suited, the other version. 10, 9x. Probably will slow play some of his sets because he thinks I'm very aggressive. Need to be cautious here. Check back and probably safely fold on rivers. My hand is still alright, but definitely not alright a bit. Again, do I bet? If you bet, I think it's quite easy. Jack 10 suited, two combos, queen jack suited, and another two, queen 10 suited. There's some bluffs, but not many. My hand is really bad, so versus a bet, I think I'm just gonna fold. I wonder if he was gonna. What are you trapped twice? Just check call and check again with a set. He's probably gonna bet king queen. He could have, I don't know, does he call with 10s? It's 9 suited, isn't there the gun that doesn't have many 9s? I don't know. I could go small, I could just safely check. Do I bet like 4,000? Is that gonna bluff me? Nah, I don't think he's gonna bluff me. He can call me, I don't know. Does he call me enough? Doesn't look, I don't know. Alright, let's see. Tens, tens is good. Yeah. Maybe I left 4,000 on the table. What are you doing? Oh well. It's alright. Maybe we would have folded, I don't know. Pretty standard. Definitely can play this one. Getting a lot of hands. This is a really good spot. I've been so aggressive. My image is quite loose. This could really pay off. Kush calls again. My old friend. It's short stack, so this could be a pretty good spot. What does he have, like 10 bigs? Yeah, I think he's like 10 bigs this turn. So 21 times 3, that's 63. 78, yeah, 78 in the middle. The guy has like a pot size bet. Okay, probably overkill. Still one ace left, so. Have an easy bet. I'm afraid I might not get enough action. Let's see if the guy picks up something. Okay. The pot is like 11k, something like that. How much does he have? He has like 66. This is a pretty good card. Second flush draw. Maybe I can stack him if he has like king 10, king queen. Maybe queen jack of spades, something like that. I think he just got a shove. There's a lot of hands. I think I can just make him to call. And there's two flush draws, straight draws. Let's put him in. What do you have? Oh, you're dead.
King jack.
Yeah, and look. Look. That was a good turn.
I have one of those to go. Jacks, aces, jacks.
That's my time. Jack is coming in for 30. Best of luck to you guys.
Play. A 10. I had a 10 versus. That was a good one. You liked it?
The
10? When I said I had the 10.
Yeah.
I was going to hold my own, but then you were about to love it. Like, that was a really good one.
I like that.
Yeah. I think it was just going to stay
what
here.
It's worth,
I
mean, you and him, he heard it too.
Yeah, you got it as well. Yeah, you got it as well. But I don't think
he heard it too. No, he did the same thing with the...
With the queen. Yeah. Okay, you got it.
I got it. Yeah.
You got the reference.
Yeah, yeah.
The bad thing. Really nice table, but a bad table. Just keep getting hands. Oh, this guy. I know this guy. Israeli professional. Should be aggressive like all the Israelis. Let's see what he's gonna do. 45. 35.
21. It's alright. I got you.
35.
You're inventing the wheel now?
Yeah, you can make it 35. You can make it 32 if you want.
Alright, interesting.
What'd you start with?
Sam Graffin voice. Why are you so noisy, mate? I think I'm just gonna call. I don't know what he's doing. I've never seen him with his clicks. I have a pretty solid hand. I don't want to go for a bet. I think he expects me to go for a bet. I think I'm just gonna flat. Hand plays well. He should have something, at least with playability. It's not super strong, but...
I don't know. Let's just see what the board brings. Shouldn't have many ace kings. Ace kings usually go a little bit bigger. Ace king suited is above. Okay. Quick check. Could have something like my hand. Probably bet some of his bluffs. See, if he checks again, I'm probably good. He goes big. Okay, 25, it's like, what is that, 1/4? Doesn't look like I'm good, but I don't know. Maybe we're gonna. Can't really fold the 1/4 at the moment. What does he have? Like, he's 5 suited. He's probably gonna go bigger sizing, so. Could have something like ace jack suited, ace queen suited. Especially suited because it went small. But let's see, I don't know. I'm just gonna call one and see what's up. The guy's tricky, just min bet. Min 3 bet, so. I'm gonna pay him off once. Backdoor clubs is there. Have some of those, like ace jack of clubs, possible. King queen suited is like likely as well. He wants to take value, go small, that makes sense. And then he just checks back for deception. Obviously, aces, which is only one combo, king, only one combo. I don't think I can be bluffing. Alright, if you bet, you're gonna have it. Do I shove this? No. I don't know. Looks like I have an ace. I actually have an ace. Some of my aces are flushes. Min 3 bet, he checked back. He got small, and I don't know if the guy's bluffing.
How much? It's 11?
Yeah.
Ay.
Let's see if I can get a read here. Is he turning like jacks into, I don't know. For me to win. Bunch of money. Only in Vegas you're playing a pot, then you see a rack of 5k. Yeah, he would have to be really, really, really creative for me to win here. He is creative. He did 3-bet to 3.5k. That's creative. What do guys? What do they think? Kind of on the bottom of my range. I actually wanted to fold there. So. So. Okay. Wanna give me something? If you bluff me, you earn it. If you bluff me, you definitely earn it. Good players, the Israelis. They used to be bad, now they're pretty good.
Busto?
Cuidado de la derecha, eh?
Sí.
Portate bien. Difficult
one. Vamos,
Shannon. Hablas muy bien español.
Poquito.
Por izquierda o derecha, vale, no.
No hablo mucho, pero puedo
You don't have to be a polyglot.
English, sorry.
This was English, it's just bad English.
Not the king's English.
No, this guy is from abroad. Actually, we were.
Yeah. I've been raised, 22.
Leeds abroad.
No, I lived in Venezuela for like two years when I was young.
Okay. Caracas?
Caracas. Mi madre es de Colombia.
Keep getting hands. It's a nice one. Let's see a flop. MacGyvery. Move the gun. He's not a professional, he's playing pretty well. Usually on the tight side, so. Not the best board. Got some backdoor equity. Does he see bet? Yeah, I think he's good enough to see bet wide. Especially this size. We've been chatting. And even though he's not professional, he clearly knows how to play. Turn, this could be a problem, let's see. Let's see if I pick up some equity or if it slows down. He could have some jacks, he could have some ace queen, ace 10. I don't know if he's gonna, I don't think he's gonna run a big bluff on me. My hand's quite vulnerable. All my range is quite vulnerable. If he knows that. I could really get exploited here on the turn. Okay, that's good. Probably good now. Well, don't like this 10. He's, yeah, he probably, he could have his queen. And shut it down. Check 10. Well, just gotta check and hope he doesn't bet. If he bets, probably fold. Let's see. So, bet, check, bet. How much is this? What is it, like 40%? Suited is a problem, Jack 10 suited is a problem. Could he could have King Queen that he decides. He could have King Queen, just play the little side on the turn, that's possible. That's a lot of combos, it doesn't look good. Okay. Yeah, I did see bet 3 way. Bet check bet, it's not usually aligned. It's bluffed here, so. Versus some guys, this could be.
C'est une leçon de prudence, Joao. Dans cet épisode, tu as reçu beaucoup, beaucoup de belles cartes. Mais un bon joueur de poker, c'est aussi quelqu'un qui sait s'en séparer quand il le faut. Et puis, ce tournoi de No Limit Hold'em à 5 000 $ ne fait que commencer, et il te reste encore plus de 100 blindes. On découvrira très vite ce que tu vas en faire, dès le prochain épisode de Dans la tête d'un pro.